In the previous classes, we were discussing about controlling, right? What is controlling? What are its uses? And what are the different process? Basic control process, right? What is controlling? So as we have seen, controlling means we are here. So controlling is the process of setting standards, measuring actual performance, finding out the deviation, and taking the corrective action so that the organizational objective and the plans to attain them are accomplished. So basically, controlling means what are we doing here? We are setting out the standards. First and foremost thing is we are setting out standards. Okay. Then we are measuring our actual performance. So once we have set out standards and measured our actual performance, we can understand whether there is a deviation or not. Okay. If there is a deviation, then we have to take the corrective steps. And why do we do this thing? Because we have to attain the organization goals. We have the objectives, right? We need to reach our goals. That has to be accomplished. Plus, the plans to attain the goals are also accomplished. We are seeing to that both our goals and the plans are fulfilled, right? Now, what is the importance of this controlling? The importance is, first and foremost, it is the basis of future actions, right? Our future steps, future plans, future scheduling, everything will depend upon this controlling, right? Then it facilitates decision making because we know where the deviations are taking place, why the deviations are taking place, we can understand and we can take the corrective decisions. Then ensure standard, because we are making sure that we are abiding to the standards which we have set forward. Okay, in the beginning, we are setting out a standard, say like 1,000 pens. 1,000 pens, each pen will write a distance of 10 lakh kilometers, right? Like that, we are setting out a standards. Then it facilitates decentralized. So, because decentralization means we are distributing our authority. Okay, the authority is not confined to one person, it is being distributed to many. So, here also, controlling process means we have to understand what is the deviation, what is the reason for deviation, and we are taking corrective steps. So this cannot be done by one single person, right? Standards has to be set, actual performance has to be measured, then deviations are to be understood, then corrective steps are to be taken. So all these things will not be, it's not humanly possible for one person to do. So we are forced to do decentralization. It ensures or facilitates decentralization. Then it ensures effective and optimal usage of resources. Again, we are seeing that we are meeting our standards. So, and if there is any deviation, we are also identifying that. Okay, so ensures that we are effectively and optimally. Okay, optimally means not more, not less. Okay. We are utilizing our resources. Then facilitates coordination. So all this stuff. Again, we have said decentralization is necessary. So there is a coordination between different teams. So overall efficiency will be improved and the quality will be improved. It can, we can respond to environmental changes and basically attain competitive advantage, right? Now then we saw basic control process. What is the basic control process? So controlling literally anywhere, okay, wherever is the controlling take place, okay, whatever is being controlled. Whether we are controlling for a rocket engine, the manufacturer of a rocket engine, or we are controlling the manufacturer of a safety pin. Okay. Whether it is being done in NASA, whether it is done in Batano. Okay. Wherever it is being taken, and whatever is being built, whatever is being controlled, step controlling will remain the same. Okay. What is the first step? The first step is establishing standards. Right. So, what are the first step is? Begins with planning and establishing standards. We need to understand what the standards are. We need to plan for it. We need to establish the standards. Okay. Basically, what are these standards? Standards are criteria of performance. Right? How much can we do? Okay. What can be done? And whenever we are saying standard, it should be very clear. It should be very clear. It should be concrete. That means it is not open to interpretation. Okay. Everyone will be understanding the same. When you say 1,000 pens, It can be 500 black, 500 blue, 500 red, 500 black. Okay, 500 black, 250 red, 250 green. Not clear. But if you say 1000 black ballpoint pen, so it becomes very clear. It becomes concrete. Nobody can misunderstand it. So it becomes clear, concrete, and it should be measurable in nature. So whenever we are talking about the standard, it should be measurable. That is, it is quantifiable. So standards are selected points in the plan. Okay. Like whenever you are writing a program, you debug it, right? Whenever you run up on it. And whenever you see that the output for the errors are impacted. Similarly, these are standards of selected points in the plan. Okay. So even when you're doing the software will prompt you. Do you want to save this file? Do you want to save this file? Right? That's a control. Okay, that point is control. Standards are selected points in the plan at which performance measured. Okay, at this point, we'll be measuring our performance. What has he done so far? Right? We like your series exams. So you'll have your first series, you have second series, you have your model exams, and you have your final exam. So what is being measured in final series one? What have you learned? It's giving you an opportunity to understand what you have done so far, right? So what is being done can be identified. So it's a standard point in the plan at which performance are being measured. And this will give the manager an idea about how things are going. Okay. So be seeing your CVC exam marks, your parents, your teachers can know what this kid has been doing, whether he has been studying, okay, or whether he has been goofing around, right? So similarly, when we say controlling the management, controlling gives the manager an idea about how things are going, and then he does not have to watch every step in the execution of plan. So seeing your mark, your parents can know whether you have studied or not, whatever you have been spending your time on what, right? So he or she doesn't have to look at you every day, just get you at your results. So if it's not up to the mark, then he or she can, the parents can put up more and more checks on it, right? That is the first thing, so establishing standards. The second thing is measuring actual performance. Okay, the performance measures are expressed both in terms of quantitative and qualitative terms. Okay, so here, whenever we are thinking about performance, whenever we're measuring performance, we need to take into account the both quantitative and qualitative, because certain things might be in terms of quality, right? Standard expects, say, only one has been produced, but it might be a one high-end craft. Okay? The other one may be produced, hundreds may be produced, but it may be machine-produced, right? Mass-produced, but one. The item may be produced, only one single item is produced, but it is of the best quality. So you have to take in terms of quantity and qualitative data, right? Whenever you are measuring the performance, right? Then comparing actual performance against the standards. So we have a set of standards. We have decided we need 1000 pens, 1000 black ballpoint pens. Each pen will write a distance of 1 lakh kilometer, right? That's our standard. Now we'll measure. We'll see whether our pens are doing the same. So actual performance compared to the set standards. And deviation can be identified. Deviation can be defined as the gap between actual performance and the planned target. So what have we planned for? Okay, we have planned for certain things. What is the one which we are getting? So actual performance can be more than, less than, or equal to the standard. So can be we have produced 1001 pen. Okay, we might have produced 1001 pen. We are more than our standard. So we have gone below the standard. We have produced only 999. Right? We are going under our target. So we may be equal to 1000 pens. Right? So this is we have to find out the deviation. Now, what we have to do? We have to do the correction for deviation. So this much is the correction to be applied. So in the first case, we have gone above target. So, well in it. Second case, we have gone one below. Right? We need to correct, make sure that we produce one more. So, that's the deviation. Correction for deviation has to be done. Right? So, based on the results, managers can know where exactly correcting measures must be applied. So, and how can this be done? One is maybe redrawing the plans or modifying the goals, right? Because sometimes what will happen is 1000 pens is not possible. Okay, it's not physically possible. bring the 1,000 pets. And that scenario, we need to revise our plan. Okay. The second thing is, that is about a plan. Reassignment of clarification duties. Maybe duties, we are not meeting our goal. It is possible, but we are not able to meet our goals because of the personals involved, right? In that case, we need to clarify their duties. Maybe we have to reassign them, okay? Like somebody may be in production, he might be better in packaging. Okay? Like this, we need to reassign them, okay? In some cases, what I have to do, we have to appoint additional staff, okay? Additional staff has to be appointed in some cases. Or sometimes what happens is, we have to train them. Okay, they may be lacking in some training. With some training, they can improve. So we can train our subordinates. Or in the worst case, we need to replace them. We need to fire them and we need to hire a new person. Okay, fire and hire. Right. That's about subordinates. The first one is about our basic plan. The point 2 and 3 is about subordinates, and the point 4 is about the leader. So the leadership technique which he or she has been applying is not up to the mark. In this case, the leader has to change himself. His techniques has to be changed. Okay? Basic control process remains same for all the process. Okay? First one is setting standards, actual measurement, finding out the deviation, and then correcting for deviations. How can the deviations be corrected? One is by redrawing the plans or modifying the goal, then by reassignment or clarification of duties, by additional staffing, training, or even firing. Okay. And the fourth one is changing our leadership technique. So this is the basic control process. Right. Now coming back. Next topic is control as a feedback system. So this controlling process, it can act as a feedback system. Okay. So what does this feedback system mean? The feedback refers to the process of adjusting future action on the basis of information about the past. We know we have some past experience. So we had to change our future actions according to the past. Okay. We'll say, everyone will learn from their past mistakes. So that's the principle over here. We have made some mistakes in the past and we have identified the mistakes in the past, and now we are making sure that it will not happen again. Right? So when in the past you had 60. Steadily, and you put 1 day for each module, okay, or 5 days for 6 modules and 1 day for revision. So as and when you wasted your time, at last what happens? 1 day and 6 modules. Okay, I have made a mistake like that. Now I will not repeat the mistake. Okay, that's the feedback system. Okay, that is you are correcting your future. You are adjusting future action based on the past performance. Okay, now how does this system work? So actually, we are having a block diagram. Okay. So as you can see, there are steps before that also. Okay. Before that, there is step. Now we have reached a desired performance. Okay. There is a desired performance. There is planning. There is staffing, controlling, staffing. All these things will be there before. But we have to look into here only. We have a desired performance system. So we have a desired performance. That is 1,000 pens, 1,000 black ballpoint pens. So each riding 1 lakh kilometer. Right. That's our desired performance. Then we have our actual performance. Right? We how much have we produced? Now the next step is identify the measurements of actual performance. The same thing what we are doing, basic control process itself, right? We are saying control as a feedback mechanism. Then how can we use control as a feedback mechanism? So first we have to do the controlling. So there we have the desired performance, that is our standard. We have our standards, then we have our actual performance there, then we have our measurement of actual performance. Like we have to, then we need to compare the actual performance against the standards, right? Then identification of deviation, right? Then corrections, analysis for what is the cause of the analysis or deviation. We have to analyze the cause of deviation, right? Then we have to program for corrective action. We have made some corrective action. So these steps 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So desired performance or standard action. connection. Where are we implementing connection? Implementing connection. At the stack overflow. Train. We need to train them. We need a new person. We need to replace a new person. That's not correct. And we we are finding out we are missing the result, right? So based on the result, we are finding out. So, feedback control is the one in which the control is on the results of the work. Okay? It is also called output control, corrective control, or post-action control. So everything is after the work. Okay? We have after the results only. Okay? So desired performance, actual performance. So after measuring the actual performance only, we are going for the corrections, right? So here it is post control. Okay, it's post action. Post action control, it's output control, or corrective control, right? If I look at it once more, what is feedback control or feedback loop of management control? Here, what happened? We have a desired performance, you know, we have what is the standards. 1010, right? Then what is our actual performance? We know we have to look into what is our actual performance, whether we have met or not, right? Then measurement actual performance. No? We need to measure what has been done. Then compare it with the standards. Once it has been compared, then we need to identify the deviations. We need to analyze the cause of deviation. What has caused the deviation? Okay? Maybe the raw materials will come on time. Maybe the person in charge was lacking. Maybe the machinery was not up to the mark. Whatever is the cause of the deviation, we have to analyze it. Once we have analyzed the deviation, we need to find out the we have to formulate corrective steps. We need to program corrective actions. And once these corrective actions are made, we need to implement them. And where are we implementing? We will implement the desired performance itself. We may change the desired performance. Clear? So what is the principle here? Everyone can learn from their past experience. Okay. The next one is feed forward. Control the information is fed back in the process to take corrective actions. Like we have said. Right? The next thing is feed forward. The other one is feedback, which is feed forward. Okay? From the name term, you can understand it's different. So feed forward control. It means can be it is also known as input or steering control. Okay. Just learn the terms. Feedback is also output control, post action control, and corrective control. Okay, output control, corrective control, or post action control. Okay. Feed forward control and we are inputting. Right? Input means input control or steering. So we are driving it out, right? So steering control. So what feed forward when the managers implement control even before the activity begins. Okay. In feedback, what happened? In feedback, after the result has been given. Okay, after the control was done after the results. Okay. In feed forward, even before the activity is commenced, we are putting control measures. Okay. So the aim is to solve the problem before they occur. Okay. It focuses on human resources, physical resources, and financial, which are the inputs. Okay, human, physical, and machinery and all machinery materials that will all come under physical and financial money. These are the inputs. So these all the three things are focused on. Okay, this control tries to minimize or prevent the performance deficiency precautionary control system. Okay, one example what we can make is whenever you are going for a travel. Okay, Whenever you're going for traveling, what will happen is you will carry a power bank with you, right? Even if your mobile phones are having the charge, you will carry an extra power bank with you. Why are you carrying it? Because it's a preventive control. Because if you cannot charge the phone while you're traveling, you can use a backup power bank, right? That is speed forward control. You are anticipating a problem. The battery of my phone may die, right? So I need to charge the phone. So I need to carry a power bank. You are anticipating a problem and you are taking corrective steps even before the problem has arrived. Okay, what would have been in feedback control? Once your phone has died, you'll find out the charger and you will plug in the charger. Okay, that is feedback. But in feed forward, you have the problem. You are anticipating a problem that your charger, your phone may die, right? So you need to charge it. You need to charge it means, so you need to carry a power bank. That is basically feed forward control system. Clear? So here, the managers implement control even before the activity begins. Okay, you might not have used your phone yet now, but you have carrying a charger with you. I'm sorry, a power bank with you. It is called feed forward control. The aim is to solve the problem before they occur. So here, the human resources, physical resources, and financial resources, all the inputs are focused on. Okay? It's not the one or the other. Okay, sometimes what will happen, you carry some money, extra money, right? That's not for spending, but in case of an emergency, you may keep it in your mobile phone's cover. In case of an emergency, you may use it, right? That's like that. This control tries to minimize or prevent the performance deficiencies through a precautionary control system. So when your mobile phone's charge dies, have a backup plan, right? The success of the control depends on the abilities of the managers to anticipate problems and achieve timely intervention. So it will depend upon you. Okay, what is your ability to think forward? That you have the ability to think that my phone, I have to travel this much time, I may not get the opportunity to charge. Okay, maybe I'm going for a tour, right? In my tour, like 40, 60 students are there, 60 people are there, all of them will have their phone, they will have their more cameras to charge, so I may not get the port. So I need a power bank. So the success depends on your ability, the ability to anticipate the problem and achieve timely intervention. Right? So that is feed forward. So feedback based on our results. Feed forward, we are anticipating the problem and we are making the corrective steps. We are not beginning the activity. We are not started our production. Okay, our 1,000 pens, we have not started the production. But we are seeing, we are trying to find out what may be the causes, what may be the faults that may occur. Success of the control depends upon the ability of managers to anticipate problems and achieve timely intervention. Right? That is feed forward. Now, what are the requirements of feed forward control system? Make a thorough analysis of the planning and control system and identify input variables. Okay? So we need to identify everything. Okay? We need to make a thorough analysis of the plan, our control system, and we have to identify what are the input variables. Okay? So here, in our case, the input variable was the charge, okay, the charger. So phone is a must. You need to take your selfies, you need to take your photographs. So you need to listen to music maybe, but so that's your input, right? Develop the model of the system. Now, model of the system, maybe you need to create a simulation, right? You might have seen a simulation. You basically, computer science engineers, you have created a lot of simulations. And you change the input variables and see what is the output. Okay, basically what you're doing, we are conducting an experiment. Okay, to develop a model. Okay, model means model. How do we define a model? Model means representative of a reality. Right, globe is a model of the Earth. Right, to develop a model of the system, that basically you do simulation, then review the model to see whether the input variables and the interrelations continue to represent the realities. So you need to review the model. So once you have created the model, once you create a simulation, you need to review that. You change the variables, see what are the changes that is occurring. Okay. So maybe creating a physical model, or maybe a computer model. Okay. Collect data on the input variables regularly and put them into system. So you need to update the system, right? you say ANN or artificial neural network, machine learning, all these things. We are like that. You input the changes in the variables continuously and see what is the output. Okay? Regularly assess the variations of the input and evaluate the impact on the result. Take actions to solve the problems indicated by the model. So the model will tell you. So this is the possibility. Success or scenario failed. Scenario success. Right? So that has been entered. If we compare the feedback and feed forward system, basically we have the standards, right? Desired standards are there. You know what is desired. We have our input, we undergo some process, and we got our output. So this is our performance, actual performance. Output is the actual performance. Okay? Now we need to compare it to the desired output or standards. Okay, so if it is that the deviation will be given as the feedback. Right? If it is a feedback system, the feedback will be fed into input, the feedback may be fed into process. Okay? How are we doing? Okay? Maybe we didn't get the raw materials on time. So that comes under input. Maybe our machinery is not up to the mark. Then we go to the process. So that's the feedback system works. So you have your input, you have the process, and you'll get your output. So once your output has been reached, that output will be compared to the standards, desired output, right? And the deviation will be understood as the feedback. Okay? What is the cause of deviation? What are the corrective measures to be taken? That will be the feedback. And that feedback may be fed to input or may be fed to process, right? So that is feedback for the system. In feedforward system, what happens? You have an input, you have a process, you have an output, and you have a standard desired output. Okay? But before the process starts, we have feedforward. We have anticipated what may be the problems that may arise. Okay, what can be the issues? Okay, we are going for a tour. We are traveling for this time. We need to enjoy that. Okay? So input is we are going for a tour. We need a mobile phone. The process is we are traveling. Output is the selfies. Right? Now you need a feed forward. A camera should have battery. Okay. So I need to carry an extra backup. Battery backup should be carried. So I am anticipating a problem, and that becomes my feed forward system. So feed forward, I can change into inputs, or I can add into process. Okay. Maybe I make sure that my vehicle is having like chargers. Okay. That becomes process. So that's how we compare feedback from the output. From output, we are going for feedback to process and inputs. In feed forward, it is before the process starting itself, we are giving the corrective measures to inputs and process. Okay, so black lines denote information and red lines denote corrective action. So feed forward system monitors inputs into process to determine if the inputs are as planned. Okay? So we are monitoring the what are the inputs we are going. We know we have to have this kind of input. So this much of amount, this much of plastic pellet should come in, this much of ink should come in, this quality of ink should come in. We know what is amount and when the amount should come in. We have proper idea about that. And we are making sure that the inputs are going as per the plan. If they are not, the inputs or processes change in order to obtain the desired results. Okay. This is not, we need to change. Okay. It's not coming in as we have expected. We need to change there itself. Okay. We should not wait until the process is over. Okay. So we sometimes the raw materials came in late. So what we'll do is say, okay, for this time, we'll do an extra shift so that we can keep up our production. Okay. So that is feed forward stuff. Just go through this, understand what it is. Okay. When you read once or twice, you'll get a proper idea. Okay. You'll have a decision making if you need. Now, what are the requirements of an SPI control? One is tailoring controls to plans and positions. Right. So, tailoring control means what? Do you have ready made shirts and you have tailored shirts? Okay. In ready made shirts, what you go? First, you'll go, you'll have your large or medium or XL, right? You will find out that particular size and you'll wear it and see. That's ready made. Tailored means you'll go to the tailor, will measure it, take measurements, and it will be for you, according to your body measurements, it has been stitched out. So, medium can be worn by anyone, But a tailored suit, a tailored shirt means it will suit you properly. But similarly, tailoring controls to plans and positions. Tailoring controls to plans and positions means the control system must suit the nature and needs of jobs to be controlled. Okay, we cannot put in control system commonly. Okay, if you are preparing, if you are making a jet engine, the control system will be different. If you are making a safety pen, the control system will be different. You need to understand what is the nature of the job. Okay? What is the job? What is its nature? What are the needs of the job? All these things has to be understood. And then you need to tailor accordingly. You need to fit accordingly. Okay? You need to fit the controls, plans, and positions. Okay? That's the first thing. Then tailoring controls to individual managers. Again, managers' stand will all be, also different. Right? Each manager will have their own style. So the control system should suit the manager. Okay? So it should be tailored to the manager also. The third thing is making sure the control points are at critical points. Okay? We said the standards, there are specific points in the plans. There should be important points in the plans. Okay? Wherever it is the most important junctions, we have to understand. We have to understand, we have to identify the most important junctions and then make a plan. Then make sure that control points are there at that particular sections. Okay, it should be objective. Okay. The control system should be objective, should be accurate, should be unbiased, and it should be impersonal. Okay. So it should not be said that it favors one person. Okay. It should be accurate, should be unbiased, should be objective, and it should be personal. Okay. It should not favor any one person in particular. It should equate to all equally. Should be economical and easy to maintain. Okay. They are more effective when they achieve the maximum output and minimum cost. You should be know. Okay. So the control measures should be, we should be able to maintain them economically. Okay. If we have to spend more and more amounts on the control measures, what will happen? In the long run, we may feel in order to save money, we may go back on the control measures. Okay. That will bring down our standards. It should be economical. It should be our motto should be maximum at minimum cost. Okay, achieve maximum output at minimum cost. It should be economical and easy to maintain. Okay, the control mechanism should be flexible. It should be flexible. Flexible in the sense, we have to take the scenario into consideration. Okay, when the environment changes, like now we are in the pandemic situation, so that whatever we have been doing in the traditional sense of the way has to change. Our control system should be also flexible, should be able to adapt to the situation, right? It should be flexible enough. It should fit the organization culture. So we are seeing every organization will have its own culture, right? Every single organization will have their own culture. So it should fit the organization culture also. It should lead to corrective action. Okay. So it should not be that they will show you what is the reason. Okay? Only the reason. What is the problem? It should not be like that. It should be, you should be able to identify the real problem, and it should lead to a corrective measure also. Okay? Anyone can point out the problems, but finding out the corrective measure, it is difficult. It should lead to corrective action. It should disclose where the failures are occurring and who is responsible for them. Okay? So we know the 1,000 pens have to be created, and we can count and see. We have not created 1,000. We have created only 900. We are 100 short. That anyone can do. But who is responsible for that 100 shortage? Okay. What caused that failure? That has to be shown by the control measure. Okay. It should point out the required corrective actions also. Okay. This is the cause. This is why we couldn't make 1,000. And we can do this to correct that. Okay. Okay. We have produced 900 pens. We have not met our standard of 1,000. We have 100 short. This is the reason for the shortage, and this is how we correct the shortage. This is what a control mechanism should be. Clear? Okay. So, what are the effective control requirements? One is it should be tailored to the plan and position. It should be tailored to the managers. Make sure that the control points are critical points. Because there are numerous points will be there in the plan. Okay. See, even if you are preparing a curry. Okay, you will test the what you will not put above your putting so the like chili powder, then you may put the turmeric powder, you may put salt. You will not taste every time, right? You will see the finally you see the salt is there, whether anything is missing or not, right? That is the critical point. Just before you are placing, just before you are starting to cook, you'll see that whether everything has been correct, whether you have forgot to salt or not. At that point, you'll try it out, right? So that is the control point. You need to identify the critical control points and work accordingly. So control points should be, and control should be objective, accurate, unbiased, and impersonal. And it should be, the control mechanism should be economical. Economical and easy to maintain. It should not be complicated. It should be economical and easy to maintain. Because if we spend more time, more effort on it, we may not use it in the future. Okay? So our aim should be maximum at minimum cost. Okay, maximum effect, maximum result, maximum output at minimum cost. And it should be flexible and should fit the organization culture and should lead to corrective answers. Because it should not just show what is the shortage, what are the shortcomings, but also who is responsible there, what is the cause of the failure, and how can we correct them, right? That's the control feedback and forward, and also about the FAT control, requirements of FAT control. So we'll stop here for today. So if you have any doubt, please let me know.